Daisy. That's the name of my favorite album of all time. But there's something kinda special about this album that I really want to talk about in this video. Daisy is a 2009 album by American emo rock band Brand New. It's their fourth album and also their second to last. It only has 10 songs and a little interlude, and it also happens to have my favorite song of all time, Noro. But there's a little aspect of it that has like nothing to do with the album itself or the music. It's more about who made the album and what it means for the record. Today I'm gonna be talking about the tragedy of my favorite album, and also the concept of separating the art from the artist. But first of all, what even is Brand New? As you can tell from the live footage, they're a pretty aggressive rock band. They started making music in 2000 and they released their first album in 2000 as well. Their first album was called Your Favorite Weapon, and it was just like a pop punk album with nothing else. It was kinda boring actually. It has like 3 or 4 great songs, but it's very tame in comparison to what they would be doing next. 3 years later, they would release Deja and Tendu, which was way better than Your Favorite Weapon. This album is widely considered to be an emo masterpiece, and I actually kinda agree. Despite the very long and gimmicky and emo titles, it has aged pretty well, and I actually still like it to this day. They followed this album up in 2006 with The Devil and God Are Raging Inside Me. I used to be completely obsessed with this album, but now I think it's just alright, I guess. I mean, don't get me wrong, the songs in here are pretty well done, they're really catchy and all, but some of them are just drowning in pretentiousness. And that's a problem they would fix in their next album, Daisy, the album this video is about. This album is much more abrasive and noisy than the other albums that they made. And honestly, that's one of my favorite things about it. It's so, like, real and honest, and so unpolished, I guess. But it remains catchy all the way through, and it's really, really infectious. I'm saying a lot of positive things about it, but it's actually a very dark and depressive album. The lyrics are super creepy, actually. And there's a lake. And at the bottom you'll fall, all my friends. They don't swim, cause they're all dead. That's some eerie shit. It's loud, it's suicidal, it's completely sickening. But regardless of this, I still kinda find it very uplifting, for lack of a better word. That's just really powerful and all, I really like it, it makes me feel good. The instrumentals are like completely beautiful, but also super harsh, and for the most part, the vocals are mostly just... And also, I'm not saying it's a bad thing, I actually really like the fact that it's like very aggressive, but maybe that's not something that you will like that much if you're not into this kind of music, that's what I'm saying. Perhaps you're the kind of person who doesn't want to sit in for 40 minutes listening to something that sounds like this. Yeah, it sounds beautiful, doesn't it? But I'm not saying it's simple, it's actually really complex for the most part. A lot of these songs have a lot of parts and very noisy passages as well. The lyrics are super weird and cryptic. And it just sounds like this album is haunted or something. And I think it's time we talk about the best song on the album, and also my favorite song. Track 11, Noro. Or Noro, I guess. It's a 6-minute song with a bunch of different parts and sections, and the lyrics and vocals are so fucking weird and strange and experimental, and I'm so into it. And even the melody gets really stuck in your head, even though it's really abrasive. My favorite part of the song is the instrumental explosion at the 3-minute mark. It's like, oh my god, you have to listen to it, oh my god, it's so great. Okay, maybe you have no clue what even the song is, okay? But I have to show you this because I really want to make you understand that I'm really passionate about it. Okay, here goes the clip. Good, I'm gonna fucking cry. Okay, I'm thinking maybe my explanation of the song wasn't the best, but I'm really in love with it and I want you to listen to it in full if you want to after watching this video. It's in the description if you want to listen to it. It's really good and it does not contain jump scares or weird shit. Well, a little bit, but it's a banger, so whatever. I'm on my way now. Wait. So we have to talk about the tragedy of my favorite album. It's gonna get really ugly. A few months after the band released their last album, Science Fiction, in 2017, some awful and very disturbing allegations came for Jesse Lacey, the vocalist of Brand New. Jesse confirmed these allegations on Brand New's Facebook. It's really ugly. To put it simply, he basically had some back and forths with very sexual undertones with minors, very young fans. The day I heard this, it was, you know, fucking heartbreaking. Obviously, like, it had to be. Also, I was very young and sensible when this happened, so having one of my all-time heroes be discovered to be, or to have been, a pedophile basically was really painful, you know? Basically, I did not know what I was supposed to do. The music was still incredible and I loved it, but I didn't listen to it for months because I was too scared to. I didn't feel like I was gonna like it that much anymore, but apparently not. So nowadays I have a very different view of what I have to do. I still listen to the music regardless of who made it, but I can't share it around that much because, you know, Daisy is my favorite album, but it's abrasive, it's creepy, it's loud, it's not for everyone, and the vocalist of the band did some horrible shit, and that's really awful, and sometimes that's a really big turnoff for some people. And that's the tragedy of my favorite album. It's really hard to talk about it without having the feeling of you're going to be judged because the album was made by somebody who is a bad person. And I guess I just won't talk about it much. I guess I have to keep my love to myself. And if you have any thoughts about it, just please leave them in the comments. I really want to know what you think about this. Yeah, that was the video. That was a tragedy. Thanks for watching.